Welcome to Worship with Messiah Online. A few announcements before we get into worship. Coming up during Lent, on Tuesday nights, we'll have a Zoom Bible study beginning this Tuesday, February 23rd. Our overarching topic, and we'll have several short Bible studies on this topic over the course of the year, is the Old Testament as Jesus' Bible. This first one, during Lent, we're looking at promises and problems in Genesis. You can sign up on our website. We hope that you'll do that. Also coming up on Wednesday nights, and then Thursday of Holy Week, Maundy Thursday evening, we'll have online devotionals also beginning this week on February 24. You can also look for those. With that, we begin worship in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Let's pray. Mighty God, you breathe life into our bones, and your Spirit brings truth to the world that you made. Send us your Holy Spirit to pray for us when we do not know how to pray, and give us language to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ to all who need to hear. We pray this in the name of Jesus, our Savior and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our scripture today is from Romans chapter 8, verses 26 and 27. Paul writes, "Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is in the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God." It's the end of the reading.
Jesus is the way to life. And not just life after death, but life here and now. When Jesus said, "Follow me," he meant it. In all that Jesus did and taught, Jesus conveyed that our spiritual life takes place in our physical reality, as well as in our hearts. If we believe that what Jesus says about spiritual life, it only makes sense that we should do what he did. With that as our backdrop, we're starting a new series during this season of Lent. What are you looking for? It's going to be a focus on some spiritual disciplines, including prayer, scripture, fasting, confession, worship, and silence. These are practices of Jesus that have been recognized for centuries as the core activities of spiritual life. In the same way a runner is equipped to compete in a marathon by the discipline of physical training, so training through spiritual disciplines frees us to live each day with the easy yoke and the light burden that Jesus spoke of in Matthew 11:30. Now let me be clear, these disciplines, they don't earn us any special favor with God, or they're not a measure of our spiritual success. They are, simply put, exercises that equip us to live fully and freely in a more intimate relationship with God. And through these disciplines, so much of what we are looking for in life is discovered as God works with us, gives us grace, and reveals God's very presence and our purpose in new ways. Today, we're going to focus on prayer and meditation. This is the ability to hear God's voice and then to obey God's word. Christian meditation allows for a precious, one might even say a sacred space and time for a meeting between God, the lover, and we, the loved. We can meet routinely and regularly with God in an ever-growing familiarity and intimacy, not because of any of our special abilities, but simply because we come willing to enter into a listening space. It's creating a space emotionally and spiritually in our often hectic and hurried world where we allow the Creator of the universe to meet with us, just as God met with Moses face to face, met with Moses as a friend. Richard Foster, a Quaker pastor, theologian, and author, in his profound book, The Celebration of Discipline, writes, "What happens in meditation is that we create the emotional and spiritual space which allows Christ to construct an inner sanctuary in the heart." Think about how often you pray. How often do you pray outside of Sunday morning or at meals? And how do you define prayer in your life? When it comes to a spiritual discipline like prayer and meditation, the more we exercise it, the stronger and healthier we become. Prayer is something that everybody can do. And I know that all of us, at some time or another, we deal with the issue of, am I a good prayer or a bad prayer? Or maybe you even wonder, do I even know how to pray? But what we discover throughout the Bible is that the power of prayer is in praying honestly and fervently, and that it ought to be a regular practice rather than just an as-needed or a one-time event. As our faith deepens and we develop the exercise of prayer regularly in our life, It can actually become like second nature to us, as natural as breathing. The Holy Spirit is the breath of life. And when we develop this discipline of prayer, that spiritual breathing comes to us more naturally, more easily. Now today, instead of me just telling you about prayer, I want to invite you over the next few minutes into a guided time of meditation. Over this past year, I've been experimenting and exploring various expressions of something called the daily examine. The examine is a way of prayerful reflection on the events in our day so that we make ourselves aware of God's presence and recognize God's guidance for us. The examine is an ancient practice in the church that can help us see God's hand at work in our whole experience. Now, what I'm going to share with you today is a method adapted from a technique described by Ignatius of Loyola in his writings on spiritual exercises. Saint Ignatius thought that the examine was a gift that came directly from God and that God wanted it to be shared as widely as possible. So I'd like to share with you now this guided examine, and I hope you find it comforting, relaxing, and enlightening. Wherever you are, get yourself into a comfortable position. You can actually close your eyes if you'd like and just relax. In the quiet, we open our souls to God and find life. Whether you are sitting down or lying down, just relax. Take a deep breath in. Hold it for a moment. Exhale deeply. Simply pray silently, inhaling, God, you are here. And then as you exhale, as you breathe out, pray silently, and I am with you. Do that a few times. God, you are here. I am with you. Let the distractions and the noise begin to separate and actually focus on the reality that you are with God and that God is with you right now in this place. Pay attention to your body. Are there any places where there's tension or tightness? Again, take a deep breath in. God, you are here. And now breathe out. I am with you. Try to slow your mind down. Try not to think of everything you have to do. Try to be present in this moment. Another deep breath. Try to be fully present right here, right now. Breathe in, God, you are here. Exhale, I am with you. In the quiet, we open our souls to God and find life. Try to feel open in this moment. Open your mind. Open your heart. Try to put things out of your mind that would be distracting you or anything that would be keeping you from being present in this moment. Remind yourself that you are in the presence of God, that we're always in the presence of God. Especially, and now, we're intentionally trying to pay attention. Take a deep breath in. Remember that God is present with you right here and now. In the quiet, we open our souls to God and find life. take a moment now to recall one thing that you're thankful for. Thank God for this one thing, this one gift that you've been given. Maybe it's a person who comes to mind, or a particular opportunity or experience you have. Maybe it's something physical that you're thankful for. Take a moment now just to pray about that, to thank God for that thing, that person, that opportunity, that possession. Give thanks in the quiet and the stillness. We open our souls to God and find life. Now take a moment to ask the Holy Spirit to help you freely and honestly review the happenings of the past day. Think about your interactions and the events of the past 24 hours. Recall them in an honest way. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you remember. How did the interactions you had with people unfold? Be open and honest with yourself. Be open and honest before God. In the quiet, we open ourselves to God and find life. Now look back over your past day and try to remember the key moments. On the whole, was it a good day or a bad day? Was there something out of the ordinary? Who did you spend time with? What did you do? What stands out? Does anything special come to mind? Was there a moment where you sensed God's presence with you? Spend a few moments just reliving your day, person by person, event by event. In the quiet, we open our souls to God and find life. As you continue to review your day, does anything bad come to mind? Was there a difficult situation that you faced? Maybe a strained relationship. Maybe you made a decision that you now regret. Was there a time when you were less than your best? Did you do anything that was not honoring in the sight of God? Take a moment to acknowledge this. Ask for God's forgiveness for the ways you fell short. And be excited about the opportunities and chances you have for the day ahead to do better. Take a moment and pray about these things. In the quiet, we open our souls to God and find life. Finally, look forward to tomorrow. What do you have coming up? What are you excited about? What are you dreading? Take a moment to ask for God's grace and help with whatever's coming up in the day ahead. Ask that your day will be marked and shaped by love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, and self-control. Think about tomorrow, the day ahead, and commit it to Jesus. In the quiet, open our souls to God and find life. Our Father in heaven, may your name remain holy. Bring about your kingdom. Manifest your will here on earth as it is manifest in heaven. Give us today the bread we need, no more, no less. And forgive us our debts as we forgive those who owe something to us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let your kingdom be, and let it be powerful and glorious forever and always. Amen.
Let's confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. For our love moment today, I want to take a moment to honor our musicians, the people who help us worship, who provide both music and leadership to help us spend our time in worship of our Lord. If you watch regularly online, depending on which service you usually watch, these are some of the people you might regularly see. Lily Lee, who plays organ and piano. Francisco Calvo, who is the leader of, or the musical leader of our traditional service, plus also plays piano and sings. Anita Hernandez, who also plays piano and sings. Matthew Hernandez, who plays guitar. Nancy Andeel, who is the musical leader of our contemporary service, Courtney Henson, who sings. And I don't know if you've seen her recently, but I'm told that coming up soon, you'll see Carolyn Kelly singing in one or both of these services. And with that, I'm going to ask you to join me in prayer. God of majesty, we thank you for the gift of music. We ask that you pour out your Spirit on your servants who, with the gifts of music that you have given them, enliven our praises and help us proclaim your word with power. Through their ministries, give us a new awareness of your beauty and your grace, and someday join our voices with all the choirs of heaven. Amen. Did you notice that it's free to worship with us at Messiah? If you're with us online, you didn't have to subscribe to our streaming service. You didn't have to buy a ticket. You didn't hit a paywall. When you worship with us in person, you don't have to pay to park your car or pay to sit on the lawn. There's no cover charge. Even the donuts are free. Coming to worship is free, just like God's love. Just like salvation, God loves you just as you are. Jesus died on the cross and rose because he loves you and wants a relationship with you. It's a gift. In fact, everything we have comes from God. And the truth is, we can't really pay God back. The cost would be too great. But we can give something back. When you give to Messiah, that helps support our ministries. But more importantly, giving back to God strengthens our faith. Where your treasure is, Jesus tells us, there your heart will be also. So, oddly enough, investing some of our treasure back into the work of the kingdom helps us love God and strengthens our faith. We're grateful for all of you who participate in Messiah's ministry. As a reminder, you can bring a check on Sunday or Monday morning, or you can make an online offering through your own electronic banking or our congregation's app or website. Thank you for your faithful support and participation in our ministries, and for all you do to help us love God and love one another. Now I ask you to join me in prayer. If you wish, you may put your hand over your heart or hold your hands out to receive. Merciful God, as grains of wheat scattered on the hills are gathered together to become one bread, let your church be gathered together from the ends of the earth into your kingdom, to be one in you, for yours is the glory. Open our hearts to the presence and inspiration of your Holy Spirit. Give us diligence to seek you, wisdom to perceive you, and patience to wait for you. Grant us a mind to meditate on you, eyes to behold you, ears to listen for your word, hearts to love you, and the strength and desire to proclaim you with our words and our lives. We pray this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now, Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you once again for joining us with worship online at Messiah. Today, in closing with our benediction, I want to just slow it down a little and say one phrase at a time. And much like we did earlier in the service with the prayer, to let each line just simply speak to us and resonate in our heart. And now, may God go before you to show you the way. Above you, to watch over you. Beneath you, to support you. Beside you, to be your best friend. And within you, to fill you with peace, love, and uncontainable joy. In the the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and serve our Lord with joy.